Hi everyone, it's me Tammy and I'm back with a Mommy Monday and I have Kaley with me here this time. What do you want to say? Oh. What to say? You want to say hi?
Hi.
And what's your name?
Kaley.
Okay, and how old are you?
4.
And what's your favorite color?
Pink.
Who's your best friend?
Isabella.
And what's your favorite food?
Strawberries.
And what's your favorite animal?
Pig.
A pig?
Uh-huh.
Okay, and what's your favorite cartoon?
Pig.
No, cartoon. What do you like to watch on TV?
Blippi.
Okay. All right, baby.
What?
You can go play. Okay, so she is now 4.5 years old. She is making, oh my gosh, I can't believe it. Like, she's making such great strides. She is in speech therapy. It's through university, so it's not exactly all year long, but close enough. And her last session, or her last semester in speech, that's the best way to describe it, last semester in speech, she was saying like 3 to 4 word sentences. By the end of it, she was saying 6 to 7. And now she's been done with speech, or like, you know, in break, for a few weeks now, and now she says 10 to 12 word sentences. A lot of it has to do with a growth spurt, but a lot of it also has to do with the fact that we've kind of changed up what we've been doing, so I wanted to share with you guys. In the previous video, I did speak to you guys about supplements that we were using for her. We have stopped giving her the liquid vitamins. It just didn't agree with her stomach, so we decided to just cut that part out. I'm not sure if in my previous video we discussed fish oil, but she is back on fish oil again, and we found a different one that's a little better for her and easier to get her to take. And I'm not going to go into this. I am not a doctor or a speech therapist or any of that, but I am going to say that if your child has a speech delay or has ADHD, definitely look into omegas that have EPA and DHA. So EPA, DHA, don't worry, I will post links below of the studies that I've read and of the websites of, you know, from actual parents that have used this and have seen major results. So the science behind this is that a lot of times children don't get fish oil. Kaley doesn't eat any type of fish. She just doesn't like it. There's like no way I can con her into it. So a fish oil has to be the way to get her to take it. So this is the one from Whole Foods. It's the Kids Omega 3. It's actually very affordable. She used to be on Nordic Naturals and she just, like, we could not find a way to give it to her. They now have the strawberry flavor, so maybe when we're done with this one, I'll switch over. Because this one does have a lower level of EPA and DHA than Nordic Naturals. Nordic Naturals is much higher, and we did see better results on it, but we just couldn't get her to take it consistently. So this she can take consistently. It is strawberry, and it's in a capsule like this. And all we do is pop it with a safety pin and then put it inside a drink or yogurt, especially yogurt. Yogurt works really well if it's a super creamy yogurt like Trader Joe's. They have like that custard yogurt. She will pour it in there, mix it up, the strawberry or the banana, and she just eats it right up, no problem. Normally I do 1 capsule a day, but I have been increasing to 2. You can hear her talking in the background. It's really made such a big difference. Like I said, I don't want to get into the why and the how it works. I'm not a doctor, but I will post the links below. It's amazing. Also, if your child is into actually taking chewables, I highly recommend these by Nordic Naturals. Kaylee's only finished half the box. I just can't get her to take these darn things, but I've eaten them myself. They're pretty darn yummy. It says yummy tutti frutti taste. It tastes like kind of like berry-ish. It's good. I don't know why she doesn't like it. The only thing is that they are a little bit slimy. They come in these foils like this and they're a little bit slimy, but a lot of kids like gooey things. So yeah, if your kid likes gooey things, then I highly recommend giving those a try. The other things that we've been trying or doing is we definitely read a lot more to her now. She does a lot more of imaginative play, which is a lot of what she does in speech therapy. So she plays with her dollhouse a lot more than normal. Like, I actually pulled out all the other toys. So anything that's like, honestly, anything that makes noise, unless it's singing, I've eliminated. So she plays with her dollhouse. She plays with her like doc checkup station, and she plays with her food truck. So things where she has to use her imagination. She does not use a tablet. She does not use any of those types of things. Don't get me wrong. She definitely uses my phone. She watches YouTube videos. I'm not acting like, you know, all of that stuff has been eliminated. I'm just saying that her main toys in the house while she is here are toys that force her to use her imagination and force her to speak more. So that has also made a major difference. And then something else that we find that I was kind of surprised about, I came across these brainy baby books, and the books themselves are not what are special. That's not the point. My daughter's 4.5. She knows her ABCs. She knows her 1, 2, 3s. She can say them all very clearly. She has no problems with that. It's just a lot of times you can't always understand her sentences, and sometimes you can actually hear her, or you can actually see her like trying to figure out the words she should be saying. So she'll be in the middle of a sentence and then she's just like, I don't know what else to say. Like she knows that it's in here. She can't get it to come out. So what we've started doing is at school, they read, you know, pretty complicated books, and we have complicated books for her here. However, we just feel like, for me, I felt like, you know what, let me backtrack a little bit. Let's go back to like simpler books and see if we can get her to describe things a little more. So that's what I did. So she reads the Brainy Babies, and she reads Brainy Babies ABCs and 1, 2, 3s. I got these at the dollar store. Kid you not, nothing special. Now, the reason that I think these work so much is because I will say A is 4, and she'll tell me apple, and then I'll have a conversation with her about an apple. I'll say, did you eat an apple today? Do you like apples? What color is this apple? Does Isabella like apples? And we kind of just have a conversation at each and everything. And it really does get her to speak to me more. And then the next night, often she'll say, like, she's obsessed with this dog. Her aunt and uncle have a dog, and the dog's name is Marty. And she will have a full conversation. She'll be like, Mommy, I saw Marty today. We took him for a walk. He did poo-poo. So I feel like maybe just taking it back and making it a little simpler gets them to get the words out. Same thing for the 1, 2, 3s. It's a very simple book. It's counting, but there's nothing like too crazy out there. We've been doing these books for about 2 months now, so I decided to kind of take it up a notch, but just slightly. So I've been using these Sophia books, and it's by Disney Learning. I got them from the library. It's their reading adventures, and it's their pre-level 1. So basically, it's supposed to teach your child how to read, but the reason that I like it is because it's so simple. Like, it says, I smile when I'm happy. I'm staying away from showing you what's on this because I don't want to get in trouble by YouTube for showing something Disney or whatever. I cry when I'm sad, and the girl is crying in it. I frown when I'm upset. So it's slightly more complicated than the previous books, but nothing too crazy. There isn't this like detailed storyline or anything like that. But those are the things we found to be incredibly helpful for her. I will put links to everything that I spoke about below. If you have any questions, feel free to ask, and thank you so much for watching. Bye.